गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग। या
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। दिस 30-year-old लेडी प्रेजेंटेड विद अ रेस्ड लेशन इन द एब्डोमेन।
नॉट 30 इयर्स। ओके चाइल्ड
चाय
स्मॉल चाइल्ड।
ओके
टेल यू अ डायग्नोसिस।
इट इज स्ट्रॉबेरी एमेंजियोमा इन इन्वोल्यूटिंग फेज।
What is this strawberry hemangioma?
It's like a type of capillary hemangioma.
How do you classify hemangioma?
Based on Schauber's classification.
That is not classification, that is staging. Yeah.
Yes.
Whose classification is usually followed now as far as these problems are concerned?
Not sure.
Oh.
Schrödinger's classification for staging of AVM.
So that Schrödinger's classification is for what? Is it for strawberry hemangioma? Is it for
fault
wine? Is it for AV malformations? Is it for lymphangiomas? What?
It's for AV malformations. So depending on the aggressiveness of the disease, that is first stage is quiescent, second stage is the expanding phase, and the third stage is destruction.
What is the difference between an hemangioma and vascular malformation or artery venous malformation? Let us say between hemangioma and artery venous malformation.
In an arteriovenous malformation, there is a it's a pulsatile lesion. There is a connection between
pulsatile need not be pulsatile. There are so many types of it.
There's a communication between the means arteries and
the sir is asking what is the basic pathology difference in between these two. That is what sir is asking.
High flow lesion and this are low flow lesions.
See, basically,
yes,
Doctor, sir is asking what is the pathological difference between a hemangioma and a vascular malformation, as the name itself suggests to you. One, there will be proliferation, other there will be dysplasia, which is which?
In hemangioma, there is a proliferation.
Yes.
Proliferation of what?
The proliferation of the capillaries. And then that is the proliferative phase.
Why do they have a proliferative phase and involutory phase? Why do this? What is the pathology behind it? You know, everybody has been saying, you know, they like in that patient with on the lesion on the cheek said, you know, it is an involuting phase. So what makes the hemangioma involute? you know, some changes would occur so that it involutes. Here in this patient also you see a white sort of a, yes, you know, hypopigmented area. What does that represent? Any guess?
No, sir.
Any other PG also can answer. Other PGs also can come forward. Shruti?
But they should not use the internet, you know.
Rituja?
Google Baba should be kept away.
Durga? Anybody can answer.
White areas are areas which have undergone some involution, sir.
No. What is the cause for this involution?
In this particular patient. Yeah, that was another question. But in this patient, what do you think is the cause of involution in this much of area only? By rest of the area, they are spared. Because perhaps this area got ulcerated.
Ulcerated and scarred. Yes.
Yeah. I think Dr. Lakshmi.
Sir.
Hypoglycemia is the root cause of all these problems.
Okay, sir. Shall we conclude, sir? I think it's time 8 o'clock.
Yeah.
Actually, it is well covered all the aspects. Sir.
Yes.
Strawberry hemangioma is. Akshalina?
Yes, sir.
You are able to hear. Sir is asking. Yes. Sir is asking.
Yes.
The white area. What is the thing that could have happened?
Yes,
is it a sign of involution?
Yes, that is a sign of involution. It is hyperpigmented area. It might have ulcerated and healed.
So, what exactly you want to do for this patient? Anything you want to do?
Wait and watch normally. If a patient does not have any other problem, we could advise them to wait.
Suppose if the mother is very much concerned about the ulceration.
Till when? Waiting till when?
Normally we could wait around 50% involution will be there in 5 years time.
This is a 30-year-old female.
No, sorry, that was my mistake. Because I saw only the abdomen, it is just a small child.
It's a by mistake, she wrote, sir.
Okay.
It actually is a pick of a small child.
Okay.
Magnified view. Okay, sir is asking till what time you want to wait and proceed with any intervention or anything.
If there is an ulcer, then we could give the wound care.
Patient is right in front of you. Yeah.
If nothing is there, we could advise the parents that it will just go off by itself, and once it is completely involuted, maybe even 10 to 12 years, we could wait. And if it is completely faded, we could do scar management at that stage.
Okay, Dr. Telby, if you are asked what one investigation would you do in this patient?
Ultrasound abdomen to find any other hemangiomas.
Can you see it on the surface?
Hepatic. Intra-abdominal hepatic.
Okay, fine enough, good. Sound is not clear, you know, we can't understand anything out of it.
Okay, Radhakrishna, your voice also not audible.
Hypoglycemic, I think.
Yeah.
Dr. Salina has become hypoglycemic.
In the net also.
Net also has become hypoglycemic, probably. No power at all, I think.
Overdose.
Yeah. But yes. Yeah. No, no, but it was an interesting session, and yes. I think practically we covered, you know, most of the problems which are there with these vascular malformations.
Yes.